come back to the question number 2 solution, and which the question which is already given into your PDF file, you can go to the question. I'm not going to write down the question over there which occupies the most space. I will try to solve the complete solution over here, and then I will go through the question. First I will try to read out, we'll first go through the concept and then we will try to solve the question. The question which is given over here is, a gas undergoes a thermodynamic cycle containing the following processes. So there is a thermodynamic cycle which is undergoing a gas, which is processes, each process is given over there. The process 1 to 2 is the constant pressure process, and process 2 to 3 is compression, which the region which is given PV is equal constant, that indicates like it is an isothermal process, and 3 to 1 is constant volume process, isobaric process. So in this, at every state of your process, the properties are given such a way, like for the process 1 to 2, the pressure is given as 1.4 bar and volume is given, and also the work done for the state of the process from 1 to 2 is given as 10.5. And in the second case of your process, where the condition is given like internal energy, that is U3 is equal to U2, and in the state 3 of your process from 3 to 1, internal energy difference from your state 1 to 3, that is V1 minus V3, is given as minus 26.4 kilojoules. There are no significant changes in the kinetic energy and potential energy changes. So what is we need to do is, first is, there are 4 parts which has been asked. This question is asked for June 2011 for 10 marks. So each carries about on and about 2.5 marks, 2.5 into 4. Okay. So in this, the first thing is the sketch. A is sketch the cycle on the PV diagram, which is very important. So according to that sketch, we will be able to calculate the rest of the things. Next is calculate the network for the cycle. Next is calculate the heat transfer to the process 1 to 2. And we need to show or prove such a way like the cyclic integral of Q is equal to cyclic integral of W, which is already, we have derived it from your Joule's experiment. The cyclic integral of Q is equal to cyclic integral of work for the first law of the cycle, which is applied for the cycle. So let's go through the first one. Let's try to draw the PV diagram first, and then we'll try to solve the problem one by one. Okay. So in the first thing, the process which is given is, process from 1 to 2 is isobaric process. So 1 to 2. So in this, your pressure at the inlet is given as 1.4 bar. 1 and 2. So that is a process 1 to 2. And next is, as P is equal to constant. And next is given like, second process is, what is the second process? It is isothermal process, which is hyperbolic one, and this is 2 to 3, and next is, the last is the next is the constant volume process. So in this, I need to join, so this will be your 3, and this is volume is equal to constant. Okay, so this area under this, which will give your work. So first is, the sketch has been drawn, it is clear. So let us move on to the next one. The next case which is asked is, calculate the net work done of the cycle. So how do you calculate the net work done? The first is A, which is drawn here, and next is B. So net work is equal to work from 1 to 2 plus work from 2 to 3 plus work from 3 to 1. Okay. So individually, first is we will try to calculate the work done for 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 1, and then we will substitute here, then we will get the net work done. Okay. So let us try to calculate for the first one, that is W12. But in the problem itself, the W12, the process work which is already clearly given. This W12 is equal to 10.5 kilojoules. Let us try to calculate the work for 2 to 3. For the isothermal process, let us try to calculate the work. So, for the isothermal process work, as we know, the relation for 2 to 3, that is nothing but P2 V2 ln V3 by V2. So, here in this case, to calculate the work from 2 to 3, we need to know P2 V2 and V3 by V2. So, here P2 at the state 2, for this P2, which is already it is equal to P1, because from this the process first which is given is isobaric process. Okay, since P2 is equal to P1, and also V2 is we need to calculate from here. Okay, and next is V3. What is V3? V3 is nothing but the constant volume process which is equal to V1. V3 is equal to V1. Given from state 1. Okay, so here what is P2, which is P1, which is given as 1.4. It is 1.4 which is given in bar. Let us multiply with 100 to convert into the kilojoules units. And next is V2, which is we need to calculate. And next is ln V3 by V1. What is V1, which is given, which is 0.028 meter cube. Okay, so this V2 is we need to calculate. So how do we calculate V2? That depends upon the process which is given as the isothermal process. Before that, the work is given from 1 to 2, the work is given. 1 to 2 work is given as isobaric process 10.5. For isobaric process, as you know, it is P into V2 minus V1. So substitute the value of T over here, then you get 10.5 is equal to P, which is nothing but 1.4 into 100 into V2 is what we are going to calculate it from here, minus V1 is already given 0.028. So from this V2 we'll try to calculate, which I have calculated and I got the value as 0.103 meter cube. This is V2. Now substitute this V2 over here, 0.103 and 0.3 is that value. This is what the value which I got, 103. So from this we get the work from 2 to 3 as the value which I got by calculation is, there is this work which I got as minus 18.783 kilojoules. This is what the work from 2 to 3 process which I got the value. And next is, let us go to calculate the value which 1, 2 is already given, 2, 3 we have calculated, and 3, 1 we will try to calculate. For 3, 1, as you know, the process which is constant volume process, so 3, 1 directly it is equal to 0, because for a constant volume process work is 0. So now all the 3 works is known, we will try to calculate the net work. So net work will be 10.5, which the value which is given at the start, 10.5 kilojoules, plus this minus the value which I have got, this is minus 18.783 plus 0. So finally I got the W net work as, which I got as minus 8.283 kilojoules. Okay, that is the net work done, which has been asked for the second case. And next is try to calculate the network of the cycle. Next is the heat transfer for the process 1 to 2. See, next is heat transfer for process 1 to 2. So how do you calculate the heat transfer for the process 1 to 2 as based on the application of your first law applying to the process? As we know, D dash Q is equal to D dash W plus DU. Okay, so in this, to calculate your heat transfer, first is we need to know the work which is from your 1 to 2 which is already given, and next is internal energy from U2 minus U1. According to the condition of your problem which is given, is in the process your internal energies, which is U3 is equal to U2. Since is given in the problem. Okay, and also which is given, other one is difference of U1 minus U3, which is given as minus 26.4 kilojoules. Okay, this is a value which is given. So from this, if you substitute the value, such a way like if I, which is the condition which is given, is U3 is equal to U2. So substitute U1 minus U2 is equal to minus 26.4. So from this I want U2 minus U1, because in this case integral plus U2 minus U1, where this D dash W for your work 1-2 which is already given. For your 1-2 which is already given. Okay, so I want U2 minus U1. So U2 minus U1 will be 26.4 kilojoules plus. Okay, let's directly substitute that value over here. Then we get 1-2 which is already given as 10.5 plus 26.4. So we get directly the value which I have got for this 1-2 is 36.9 kilojoules. This is for Q12 process, which has been asked as a CBIT, calculate heat transfer for the process 1-2. Okay, so three cases has been done. Let us move on to the last case, which has been asked is show that the cyclic integral of Q is equal to cyclic integral of W. So in this case, if we want to know the cyclic integral, W net is we need to calculate. That is for three process. So W net is already calculated over here, which is given. W net. I let this each value so that it will be clear to you. This is your W net for the first one. Okay, and this is your second one. Case answer. So once these W net which have got this value should be equal to the Q net value. So to calculate the Q net, how do we calculate this? Where Q net is equal to Q122 plus Q223 plus Q321. So summation of all this process of your heat transfer will give you a Q net. Cyclic integral of that should be equal to the work one. So to calculate this, 1-2, the heat transfer process which has already been calculated, as you know, it is 36.9. with the previous case itself we have done it. And 2-3, if we want to calculate the case of the heat transfer for the case of 2-3, which is for the isothermal process. So how do you calculate the isothermal process? One, by Q3, by applying the first law equation. As we know, D dash Q is equal to DW plus DU, where for the isothermal process, as we know, it is W plus 0. Why it is 0? Because the internal energy, which is for your constant temperature process, is 0. So for that case, your heat transfer, whatever it is there for the 2-3 process, will be equal to the work of your 2-3. What is you have got the value? So Q223 is equal to W223 is equal to, what is the W223 value which you have got over here? It is minus 18.783 kilojoules, which is done. The first one, which is already calculated, and second one, which is we have got the value from here, and finally Q31, which we need to calculate. Coming to the Q31, which is for the constant volume process. So for the constant volume process, apply this your first law to this. As you know, D dash Q is equal to D dash W plus DU. For constant volume process, as you know, your work is 0. This work is 0. So finally you get the value of your D dash Q, that is your Q from 3 to 1 is equal to U3 minus U1. Okay, what is already your U3 minus U1 which is given over there, which is in the case of your question itself, this is U1 minus U3 is equal to 26. So U3 minus U1 you get it as 26.4 kilojoules. Okay, which is, I got the value according to the case in the problem which is given. So now I have known all this value, which is 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 1, then directly substitute the value of this. Q net is equal to Q12. Q12 is 36.9 plus, what is Q23? Minus 18.783 plus, what is Q31? That is 26.4. So finally, the Q net value which I have got, the value is minus 8.283. It is minus 8.283 kilojoules. So this is the value which I got. So let us check this value with the W net. W net value which I got is minus 8.283. So this, therefore, W net is equal to Q net. So that is cyclic integral of your Q is equal to cyclic integral of W. Proved. So that's all the problem. You are done with this. Try to solve by yourself and then go to the PDF of your solution. And then if you still have your doubts, you can go through the video solution. And then finally try to calculate. This is a good question which has been asked. This question has been asked for about 10 marks. So each formulas and all carries equal marks, as well as the UV diagram carries the marks, and as well as the solution for each case carries each 2 marks. So totally 10 marks. I hope this solution is clear to you. We'll go with the next solution in a further class. Thank you.